Good day, everyone. My name is Valerie Weighmann, and I'm representing the Philippines. For me, it's just a blessing. Just the opportunity of competing here for my country is such a big honor for me. And at the same time, I'm so excited to see all the great tourist spots of London since it's my first time here. And I'm so eager to meet everyone here already, especially my fellow countrymen from the Philippines, since here are a lot of people already, a lot of Filipinos already working here. So I'm really excited to meet them and also show them that I'm really happy to show them my excitement for this whole journey of Miss World.
Can you just tell us what it was that initially made you want to compete for the title of Miss World?
It was actually my personal advocacy, because I'm enabling the indigenous groups, communities in the Philippines. So it's very close to my heart, this project, because I started this even way before I joined any competitions, because I'm really into this, because I met a lot during my time as a host, because I'm also a TV host in the Philippines, and my dad always made sure, my dad and my mom, to also meet them as well during our travels and everything. So this is really for them. This is really dedicated for them. And I'm just so happy to also finally showcase my Beauty with a Purpose project, which is Musika Ramay, my personal advocacy of enabling our indigenous communities in the Philippines. But not only in the Philippines, one of my biggest goals is all over the world, because I believe that indigenous communities should get the attention from all of us, because I believe we all can learn from them at the same time. So it's very important to me. Yes. I mean, for me, it's just amazing to just have the opportunity to stay in one room with 120 gorgeous girls from all over the world. And since I love to travel around the world, I like to ask them also, especially just to get the chance to get too close to them and also to go to their countries and to show them that I also love to see everything, to experience everything that they experience, to know their life stories and at the same time to get to know their cultures better. So this is such a great opportunity of getting there and talking to them and finally making my plans for my next top destination. So it's amazing. It's just amazing. I'm just excited. Excited and just so happy to be here right now, because I mean, it's not every time, it's not every day that you're getting such an opportunity like this, of working with such a great organization like Miss World is an honor. And it's really about the right mindset. For me, I'm really, rather than nervous, I'm really excited and happy about everything. And I just want to live every day as if it's my last, really, and just enjoy this whole journey. Miss World, you can see already that it's not just about the beauty. It's about each and every contestant's personal advocacies that we can showcase here. And for me, Miss World is very important. A very important pageant, because it raises more awareness for all the people, for everyone here living on this planet, to really have a personal advocacy. So for me, it makes so much sense to also support this kind of pageant, because it's not every day that we finally can showcase our personal advocacies from our countries, and to also make other people realize on how easy it is to go out there and take action instead of complaining. Because for me, it's amazing to see that this organization really makes it work. They're showing that just by pushing other people, just by showing them that we can do something about our social problems that we are facing right now, that we can do something about it. Of course, it's not easy at the start, but step by step, if all of us can come together and work as one, I mean, we can make this better. We can make this place better, and we can show them that we all care for each other.
What do you think are the biggest challenges being faced by women, particularly at the moment around the world?
Of course, the recent event that happened here to Miss Honduras is one of the best examples that we all should raise awareness of violence against women, especially, because I was just devastated to hear about the news of what happened to her and her older sister. Because just for me, by putting myself into the shoes of their situations right now, that is ongoing right now, it's just horrible to experience, especially for their mom, their mothers, I just can't imagine what she's going through right now. That's why I was really happy to see that we also had the opportunity to send our sincere condolences to the family and their friends. And it's really an eye-opener for everyone. It should be an eye-opener for everyone that we have to raise more awareness of this kind of problems that we are facing right now, us as women. So we should really come together and show them that we care for them, and we should do something about it. And at the same time, not only that, we have to be treated equally, because I guess women's rights are same like human's rights. We all can do the same. So I try my best and really show it by also joining this pageant, for example, to show them that as women we can achieve a lot more, because all of us have personal advocacies, and we want to show that we are strong as men, as at the same time we should be treated equally.
Would you describe yourself as a feminist?
I guess for me it would be feminist. Is the word right now is very used in a different way, because sometimes people would say feminists are man-haters or something. But for me, I guess you should also think about it first, because it doesn't mean that we are man-haters. We are just trying to support each other. So for me, it would be a quite balanced way of saying that I'm a feminist, because right now I just want to say that it doesn't mean that you are a man-hater. You're just trying to also raise more awareness of us women, and also at the same time bringing them in, also to show that also men care for us. So I would go out and show them also that they also have to care the same. And I know a lot of men who are also very aware of that, and who also want to help us women. So I don't like using the word feminist, but at the same time, of course, I support it, but in a very balanced way.
Do you feel a particular responsibility as a role model, especially for young women watching the competition around the world?
Yes, of course. I mean, Miss World is really the platform for personal advocacies, and I want to show the girls that you can achieve this with little steps. It may seem hard at the start, but I'm trying my best to show them also that you can do something. If you're really devastated by any news and you want to do something to make it better or to improve lives of others, you can be a people's person. But just little steps, you can achieve something. And I try my best, and I want to show them, especially through my Beauty with a Purpose project, that it's possible. And I'm really excited to really showcase this Beauty with a Purpose project, since it's my personal advocacy even way before. So I want to show them that Miss World is really a great opportunity for everyone to really come together and really work for someone's life, to really improve someone's life. I'm just amazed to see that I'm getting all the support from the Philippines, from all my fellow countrymen, not only in the Philippines, living in the Philippines, but also here, for example, because we have so many OFWs all around the world. And I'm just so overwhelmed by all their good comments and all their support. And I'm really blessed that I'm having them here also along in my journey, because I also try to make them part of it every day. That's why I try to update my page and show them that I also care for them, and I also want to be with them the whole time.